You are blessed. My name is Paula. I greet you in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, our soon and coming King. I bless you and your entire family household. Let's go to the scripture reading, the Word of God, and see what the Holy Spirit, let's see what the Holy Spirit is speaking into our lives. Today, at this point, we're reading from the book of John, chapters 1, verses 43 till 51. Jesus at this time is choosing out the 12 of his disciples. We are going to read a part of that story. Amen. Let's look at verse 43. The next day, Jesus decided to leave for Galilee, finding Philip. He said to him, "Follow me." Philip, like Andrew and Peter, was from the town of Bethsaida. Philip found Nathanael. Now here it is. Philip saw Nathanael while they were walking along the way. He knew him. So he said, "Nathanael, come." And he told him, "We have found the one Moses wrote about in the law." Notice there was no confusion in Philip's mind about who Jesus was, who Jesus is, and about whom the prophets also wrote, Jesus of Nazareth, the son of Joseph. Now the reason why Philip, just to interject a little for those who don't know, the reason why Philip mentioned the son of Joseph, in those days, one were identified, any man were identified by who was their father. In this case, it would be representing father, because we know very well that Joseph did not plant the seed of Jesus in the womb of Mary. We understand clearly this is why he is called the Son of God, because man did not do that. Are you understanding me well? Right? So Joseph, you were identified in those days by whom would have been your father in the earth, and by the place where you were from. This is how men were identified in those days. Verse 46, "Nazareth," Nathanael replied, when Philip told him, "Come, follow. Look, we found Jesus, the son of Joseph. He's from Nazareth." So Philip replied, Nathanael replied, "Nazareth, can anything good come from there?" And this is where our foundational message, our entire message that God is speaking to you is coming from tonight. "Nazareth, can anything good come from there?" Nathanael asks. "Come and see," said Philip. When Jesus saw Nathanael approaching, he said of him, "Here truly is an Israelite in whom there is no deceit." Now Jesus was prophesying to Nathanael in the category or area of what we call revelation knowledge. So Jesus was telling Nathanael of what type of person he is on the inside. "How do you know me?" Nathanael asks, verse 48. Jesus answered, "I saw you while you were still under the fig tree before Philip called you." So I saw you in the spirit, Nathanael, even before Philip called you. Verse 49, then Nathanael declared, "Rabbi." He said, oh, rabbi means teacher. So he said, "Rabbi, you are the Son of God. You are the King of Israel." Jesus answered him, verse 50. Jesus said, "You believe because I told you, I saw you under the fig tree. You will see greater things than that." Verse 51, he then added, "Very truly I tell you, you will see heaven open and the angels of God ascending and descending on the Son of Man." Let's stop right there. I want to point some stuff to you to bring about what the Spirit of God is revealing to you. He wants to open your eyes and your mind at this time. You see, Nazareth is a place very small. In those days, it was surrounded by big mountains. It went unnoticed. You see, that's the position. You are like Nazareth, the place of Nazareth. You are like Jesus the Nazarene. People misunderstand him. People saw him as insignificant at many times. Maybe you are feeling the same way. This is what you are going through in life. And I want you to know that your place of Nazareth, where you are yet small and insignificant, it also means obscure, despised. And you see, Nazareth is that place that was nothing great came out of there. Nathanael said it. Can anything good come out of Nazareth? And so the meaning of Nazareth is a little town in Galilee. That's where it was. It also means Nazareth is considered obscure, an obscure town. Now that word obscure means not discovered. And you see, you're not discovered yet. You're saying, "Paula, I've given my heart to Jesus. Already I'm serving him, but nothing big is happening for me, and God has sent me on assignment to bless you with this word. So you feel like you're not discovered or known. Obscure also means not clearly expressed or easily understood. Nobody understands you. You can't express yourself. You say, I believe God called me to preach, and yet you feel as though you can't preach. Maybe what God has put in inside of you is not coming out just yet. Hold up, it's just not the right time. But listen, it took time for Jesus to develop and to be glorified on the cross. It took an entirety of 33 years. And here you are just like Jesus, obscure, despised. You are just like that land and village that he grew up in, Nazareth, unseen, unnoticed, unpopular, and God has sent me for you. And you see, Jesus was from Nazareth, a small town in Galilee. He was not born there, but he grew up there, you see. And we can even see from the scriptures, just quickly, let's look at this one scripture. Just then a man in their synagogue who was possessed by an impure spirit, an unclean spirit, cried out, "What do you want with us, Jesus of Nazareth?" So Jesus was in the synagogue. Now I'm reading from a different passage of scripture. And the demon that spoke up out of the man actually said, "Jesus of Nazareth," because you are addressed by the place where you are from, you see, by the land, and even who is your father. And that's the thing. Even the demons knew Jesus and knew where his establishment was from. And the thing about it, beloved, in your life, you came out of nowhere good. You came out of nothing good. That's the story of most of us. We have our parts where we have our parts in our lives where we may be ashamed of, where we grew up in poverty, where we were our most uncomfortable place. Think about it. Maybe that's your position today. That's where you are at right now, and you are at Nazareth. I mean, what good could come out of there? Look at what's happening even in our country, TNT. TNT, what good is going to come out of there, you see? So I'm just using that reference. Look at America right now. America, America, what good is going to come out of there? And so we can just say about that. We can say that about just about any place and position. Notice something, however, when Jesus called his disciples, and this is what God is speaking to you right now, he never asked for a degree. I want to let you know that you are in a perfect place, feeling like nothing and feeling as though you are unseen, unheard of, you cannot express yourself, you are obscure, you appear to be obscure and despised. Jesus never asked one of the 12 disciples for diplomas, degrees, subjects, police record references. I want you to know that the Nazareth place where you are at is the perfect place where God comes and births something and cause it to rise out of Nazareth. Jesus came out of Nazareth, and he is the man of history. He is also the Son of God. Oh yeah, by the Spirit and by the flesh, and nothing can reverse it. Nothing can disclaim that, and nothing can stop it. Oh yeah, God is on assignment to bless and to move. God is looking for someone to use, and that someone is you. You are in Nazareth, a place where no one gets popular. You feel like a Nazarene. They call Jesus the Nazarene. Despised and obscure. Despised also means as though hated. That's what despised means. It means rejected. And as though hated, nobody wants to hear from you. And I'm letting you to know in this word that God is not going to choose another avenue in which to raise up a man and use him. He is going to use you. He's coming for you, coming at you. And he can use you and make you into something great in a Nazareth position. He's going to have to use the small. He's going to have to use the insignificant, the obscure, and despised. You are in the perfect place. You are not missing nothing. Don't take your life. Don't feel less than yourself. You are the perfect candidate for God to make great works, raise up, anoint, and make good usage of. Beloved, be blessed with this word and be encouraged. God can prove and show himself big and great when you are yet small, when you are humbled, when you are pressed on all sides. That is how he makes his name great. Beloved, share this food with someone. Be blessed.